Hey Readers, this is Full Duke here for Horse News. I am at the first date after Harmony Con in Dallas 2022. I almost forgot what I'm saying there. I am that tired. And I'm here with the fabulous Elley Ray Hennessy.
I wish I had glitter. I'd be throwing it in the air right now. Wow!
We have the ponies. That's close.
The glitter is here. There's the deflation of my life essence, as you can see.
The poor balloon.
You can see that the unicorn is sort of losing her jazz. Her head is tilted. I think she's asleep right now. I know how she feels. I hear what you said. Yeah. And if you can hear my voice, listen, I've lost my voice. That's hilarious.
Okay, so I'm just going to ask you a few brief questions about how things are. I mean, how did you find the convention?
Oh, come on. It's my jazz. It's my twinkle. It's my joy. It's everything that I adore about being a pony. And this time, I find that conventions are beyond what we need. We're creatures of communication. Communication is the human connection. And we long to sit around fire, singing, dancing, sharing fable, and coming together. And I find that My Little Pony conventions create that atmosphere for all of us that are longing so desperately to just hang on to one another and go, hi, I'm so happy you're here. And it is a party. It's a celebration that of the uniqueness of who each and every pony is, and that we all come together and go, wow, this is great. I feel the family of it. I feel the herd. Like, you know what I mean? It's just a phenomenal thing. And once again, Harmony Con is...
We're shopping off.
I am just... Hang on one second.
Yeah, sure.
I'm in the middle of an interview right now.
It's okay.
I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I'm sorry for interrupting.
Yeah,
it's
all right.
You.
I love you. All right. I love you too.
You guys are
really fun. I just really see you guys in the jazz, okay? Well, all right, sorry about that, gang.
That's okay.
Ponies need hugs.
Yep.
They're leaving, and that's how it goes. So that interrupt us was me saying goodbye to some genius ponies that are leaving. They're off, and I love you. Mayonnaise!
Bing-bong.
Okay, so you're with me now. All right. I'll see you soon, my loves. That's it. That's what it's all about. No, don't worry about it. Gotta hug a brony. Always hug a brony first.
Yes.
Before an interview.
Yes. Okay. How is the convention? How do you think the convention scene has changed since the pandemic?
I don't think the conventions have changed per se, other than we have to wear masks. And right now, I obviously don't have mine on because of the interview and having vaccines.
Yeah.
That's about really the only difference that I feel, because the love is there. The love is there, and it's been a bit starved, quite frankly, over the last 2 years of not being able to come together. And I just find it's like the dam opens and there's this waterfall of prisms of light going because everybody's desperate for it.
Yeah.
So, you know, coming to a convention, I actually did TrotCon in December, which was really wild because it was right before Christmas. And I flew out and it was like questionable whether I would get home for Christmas if I didn't get a negative COVID test. And it was the same sort of, you know, the hotel ran out of food. The bar had to close because they didn't have enough staff. Like, and it didn't matter. And it didn't matter. And we've moved forward a few months and we come here and their power went down on Thursday night and we had to pay everything in cash and there's no Wi-Fi. You know, so there's always going to be, the last time I was here for Harmony Con, there was SWAT Con, you know, when the bomb brigade came in and cleared everybody out.
Yeah.
There's always going to be something. The fire alarm, but there's those incidences just make the story that much, I feel, that much more exciting.
Yeah.
Like, just, there's a robot in the parking lot.
Yeah.
It's kind of like this con for me was like, what is happening? Because we had a beautiful sponsor dinner out at Whiskey Cake that was just like surreal. Like, I laughed so hard 2 nights ago. I was just talking about this in celebration of just like that liberation, you know, that my chest burst open. I had tears streamed. I was hysterical. And I feel that that's where we're at. Like, the joy just was like erupted.
Yeah.
It was just like, I was like losing it. I lost it. I was so, you know, just so overwhelmed with joy. And I laughed until I peed my pants. I peed my pants. That happened at this convention. I'm like, yeah, okay, great. I hugged a robot in the parking lot. I mean, there's so much stuff going on.
Yeah, there's always something.
The bubbles, I still brought the bubbles. I brought the helium, I brought the glitter, I brought it, the chocolates, I did what I do. The plushie, the neshi, the booby daddy, that baba bing bong. And I just do what I do. I dance, I sing, I love, and have a great time.
Yeah, so what did you say is your, what's the favorite part of the convention for you this year?
The brilliance.
Yeah.
The audience. It's the audience.
Yeah.
It's the only reason that we're here.
Yeah.
Is the fan. Mm. That's why we're here.
Yeah.
It's got nothing really to do with the show, let's be honest. The show is great, but without the audience.
Yeah.
There's no show.
Yeah.
There's no show, there's no following, there's nothing. We speak, we voice as voice actors for an audience. It's
yeah.
the only reason we do our job. If you take the audience out of it, there's no voice. So I always say, remember your audience, guys. Because of all the fabulous rooms that this world is alive and well.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the best part for me. And every single convention is just a pure love expression. And you can't bottle that. You can't sell that. You can sell the show. You can't sell what happens. It's so unique and different every single convention that you go to. You know? It's like, wow, what is happening right now? Like last night I got into the Gen 5 movie, as I was mentioning before, and when closing ceremonies had gone on, and I said, someone in the Bronies has to have the movie. I'm going, who's got the movie? Who's that? I find somebody who does.
Yes.
They get the cables, we take that huge, you know, what is that, a 10-foot screen off the wall. We take it off the wall in the lobby.
That thing there.
And we play the Gen 5 movie, and this whole area filled up. Everybody bought their chairs. I had unicorn poop candy. I had suckers. I had candy floss. And I was throwing it in the audience, and I kept screaming mayonnaise and magic and bing bong, bing bong, bing bong, bing bong. We were singing the movie, and it was like the convention was over.
Yeah.
And it was. It's never.
No.
It's never over, and you know, it's like, we sat there singing and watching the movie, and just, I went, and then we were like, let's watch it again.
Yep.
We were like, kids, man. It's just so fantastic. You just can't find it. And trust me, I live in a creative world. So I'm surrounded by that kind of stuff. Nothing touches the MLPs.
Mm.
Nothing that I've come across. And trust me, I explore the regions of magic. I go to Let's Find It.
Mm-hmm.
I find it here.
Where else do you look to find it?
Oh, I'm a spiritualist, right?
Yeah.
I'm a practicing Buddhist, but and there's much magic there. I've been a Jew, I've been a Christian, I've been a Muslim. I sort of practice just to get like a kind of a life lesson, kind of a spiritual.
Yeah.
Where you can maintain joy, because we're at a critical level of mental health crisis in our world, and we're not paying attention, and folks are really suffering. And my thing, when you say looking for the magic for me is how to keep darkness, how to keep how do we keep self-worth held up? Where
yes.
we go, I love myself. I love myself. What other people say is none of my business. What I say is my business. How do we celebrate each other instead of like, I don't like that. Like, that's weird. What are you doing? Like, instead of saying, we can all, I mean, every single spirituality says love one another.
Yes.
But we can't seem to do it. We just can't seem to do it. but the phantom can do it.
Yeah.
And, you know, I play with kids because they've got that before they've been institutionalized and damaged by a system. And the system is damaging. It causes people to not feel good enough, or and they get ostracized because they're not the thing that is the thing that everybody needs to be accepted. Like, and it's just like, come on, kids, let's go.
And that's what the G5 movement was about, wasn't it?
Absolutely. Yeah.
So speaking of audience, are you looking forward to how the audience on the show might change now that G5 is coming in?
Like, I don't think it's going to change. After I watched the movie last night with all the bronies after the closing ceremonies, they're in love.
You look forward to the newbies coming in?
It's all going to be newbies. It's a new story. It's new characters. They're completely different characters. Mm. Completely different. I am so excited about where the Gen 5 series, when and if it happened. Because it's just got so many opportunities, I think, to give just as many lessons as the main six did in Gen 5. Like, I mean, it's the main five, but, you know, there's going to be a lot of offshoots, a lot of characters, a lot of people are going to fall in love and have their favorites. Like, look, I've got Izzy, but Izzy is not my favorite character. Sunny is my favorite character. I've got her butt in my bag somewhere. I've got so many pony.
Yeah.
And are you needing a hug? Is this what's happening here?
No, I gotta
okay, interrupt us because
yes.
Brony need hug. Gotta go.
Understandable.